Hi, everyone. So the big question is, what now? What happens next? Quite a big question, because if there's anything we've learned in the past 2 or 3 months, is that we never really know what will happen now, when we're never really fully in control of what happens next. So I'm happy to share a few thoughts about things that I think are likely to happen, but you can never be 100% sure, can you? And what I did want to talk about, what I did want to share, are my thoughts about the birth of new conflicts people will face in their lives in the aftermath of the coronavirus pandemic. I think new conflicts will be born, new dramas, new stories. And I think that brands who will be able to recognize and address these new conflicts will be able to engage with their consumers in a more productive and in a more effective way. And I'm talking about conflicts such as the desire to go back to what is familiar, to go back to doing things we used to do the way we used to do them. I think that still deep inside, all of us have a portion of hope that we will be able to go back to the world, the old world as we knew it, versus the understanding that we also have that it's a new world out there, a new reality, and we need to behave differently. And then there's the conflict between the fear that we will probably still feel, the stress will probably still be under, the understanding that we don't necessarily control our lives, versus the need to control our lives, to feel like we know what we're actually doing without anyone telling us what to do, which leads to the conflict between the anger that we will feel, the frustration, the need to blame someone for what happened, versus the desire to simply move on, stop looking back at the past, stop getting sucked back to what happened, and start living the future and experiencing the new normal lives we will have. Another powerful conflict after such a long lockdown, after so much limitations for such a long time, people will want to compensate in terms of what they buy and what they do, versus the understanding that they need to behave in a more conservative way under the new reality. So I think these are very interesting conflicts. I'm sure there will be many more. And within all these challenging situations, these conflicts and pain points and difficulties, I think brands have a very important opportunity trying to help us heal from the traumatic period we just experienced. Because I think there will be a lot of situations and a lot of pain points that the governments, in spite of their best intentions, will not be able to address, leaving a space, a gap, for the brands to fill in, so the brands can step up, step in, provide a solution, maybe provide a discussion, but most of all, show people that they understand what they're going through and engage with them in a more effective, valuable, and relevant manner. So I think this could be a really interesting opportunity for brands. And speaking of opportunities for brands and roles they should play in the healing process, I think brands are in the perfect position to infect us with laughter again, bring smiles back to our faces, using their communications, using their physical or digital platforms, using their resources to bring smiles and laughter back to our lives. I think they're already starting to do that. We can see now more communications with a humoristic aspect rather than an emotional aspect. And I think this should be an important role for brands to fulfill. And that's it from me. I hope you found this interesting, and I wish you all a swift return back to a form of normal lives, back to doing what you do best, being creative.